Hey guys, what's up? This is Ross Niederhoff reporting for Complex Magazine. On today's episode, I'm going to be taking you through the headlines and inviting you to play a little game of who wore it better. Who doesn't like a little competition? Let's get right to it. Let's get down to business. Well, we all know Kim Kardashian as a style icon, but there may be someone trying to outglam even her. That's right, take a look at this. 20-year-old blogger Camilla Osman has recently made headlines for her striking resemblance to the reality TV star. But recent reports have also revealed Osman may not be doing it au naturel.
Have you had any work done to look
like
him?
Well, the only thing I did is my nose and my lips. My nose was for medical reasons. I had a deviated septum, so I couldn't breathe, you know. So that was for that. And they tweaked a bit, you know, why not?
They're there.
They tweaked it a bit. So in my lips, I did them when I was 16 or 15 years old with my mom. I'm a Walmart version of Kim Kardashian.
Even so, I think this resemblance is uncanny. So, who do you say wore it better? The original OG Kim Kardashian herself, or the Walmart brand, Camilla Osman? You know, sometimes the sequel is better than the original. Rarely, but sometimes. And moving right along to our second story, in case you missed it, I want to make sure everyone has a chance to see this. On the latest edition of Carpool Karaoke with James Corden, the late night show host invited record-breaking recording artist Adele to join him in the passenger seat, or should I say hot seat, to sing some of her own originals as well as some other hits. But one I did not see coming was this.
I heard a rumor that you, which may be surprising to some fans, are quite the rapper. You can spit some rhymes.
I'm not that talented of my own. Pull up in a monster automobile gangster. Put a bad bitch that came from Sri Lanka. Yeah, I'm in a tonga, Corolla, Willy Wonka. You could be the king, but watch the queen conquer. First thing first, I eat your brain. Then I'ma start rocking gold teeth and fangs.
So I'm going to leave this one up to you guys. Who do you say did it better? Do you prefer the original rendition by monster rapper Nicki Minaj? Or do you prefer the new rapper on the block, Adele, and her surprising flow? Let me know in the comments below. Looks like I am a bit of a rapper as well. Okay, I should never do that again. Got it. And that brings us to our final round of Who Wore It Better? I have one more story for you guys. That brings us to the most recent Republican debate. Ted Cruz and Donald Trump were at it again over election eligibility. Donald Trump says that Ted Cruz should not be allowed to run for president this election because he alleges Cruz is originally from Canada. However, Ted did respond with a pretty strong argument. Have a look.
But the facts and the law here are really quite clear. Under long-standing U.S. law, the child of a U.S. citizen born abroad is a natural-born citizen. At the end of the day, the legal issue is quite straightforward, but I would note that the birther theories that Donald has been relying on, some of the more extreme ones insist that you must not only be born on U.S. soil, but have two parents born on U.S. soil. Under that theory, not only would I be disqualified, Marco Rubio would be disqualified, Bobby Jindal would be disqualified, and interestingly enough, Donald J. Trump would be disqualified.
So I ask you once more, who do you say wore it better? Do you side with Ted Cruz or Donald Trump on this one? I'm not sure either candidate got a total knockout, but I will say Donald Trump lost some points on my scoreboard after this fiasco.
Oh my goodness gracious, what the heck would the establishment know about conservatism? Right-wing and bitter clinging proud clingers of our guns, our God, our, and our religions and our Constitution tell us that we're not red enough? Funny, haha, not funny.
Let me know what you think about this topic as well as any of the other ones covered in this episode by tweeting me at Ross Jordan Media. Thank you so much for watching. This has been Ross Niederhoff reporting for Complex Magazine.